Okay, so it has been over 3 years, and this man is still living rent-free in your heads. Landlords must absolutely hate him for never needing to pay rent. What is up, all my little spirits? Today we are talking about Kim Woojin and how his leaving affected Bangchan of Stray Kids. I am putting this out here right now. Pretty much everything that I say in this is completely speculation, theory, conjecture. Unless I state specifically that something actually happened or provide some sort of evidence or documentation, something tangible to show that something happened, everything here is just my own personal headcanon as to what I think happened. I don't know what actually happened between Stray Kids and Woojin. I don't know what happened in JYP Entertainment that caused Woojin to want to leave and break his contract and remove himself from the group. I don't know. You don't know. Unless you secretly have an uncle that works at JYP Entertainment and is in on all the work gossip and knows about everything. Like, everyone in the Pokemon community apparently has an uncle that works for Nintendo. Unless you have that very rare, outstanding circumstance, you don't know any more than I do about this. But we can theorize as to what happened between the members. So, what prompted me to talk about this all of a sudden? A couple of weeks ago, someone was tweeting a screenshot of Kim Woojin's Twitter page and noting how they had no mutual followers, and they're like, "I know that's right." Meaning that's right, nobody that I follow follows him because whatever reason you hate him for. And then the following week, a bunch of stays were getting mad because I think Woojin was scheduled to perform in Singapore like a month or so after Stray Kids, and do y'all not know how touring schedules work? You have to plan that way ahead of time, and nobody is asking every single person in the industry, "Hey, by the way, when are you planning on touring? Where are you going? What dates?" So that was purely coincidental. And then finally, the straw that broke the camel's back. So recently, Stray Kids released their first Japanese album. And by the way, you guys should totally check it out if you get a chance after this because I love it. But stays were mad because the name Woojin was printed on a clock in the background of the music video for said Japanese comeback. Fun fact, there is more than one person in this world with the name Woojin. And speaking of that quick side tangent, AB6 has a member named Park Woojin, and he is having his solo debut on the 27th of this month, so that's in about a couple weeks from now. If the name Woojin is trending on that day or the next day, I swear, do not ruin this for AB6 stans. That is supposed to be a fun, exciting, monumental day for them to enjoy the fact that one of the members is having the chance to shine individually. It has nothing to do with Kim Woojin, it's about Park Woojin, so please keep that in mind. But anyway, stays were mad that the name Woojin was appearing on a clock in the background of a music video that, personally, when I watched it, I just completely didn't notice it because I wasn't looking at such a small, minuscule detail. But they noticed it, and now they're complaining about it. I'm just thinking, this poor man had left the group over 3 years ago now. Over 2 years ago, he was falsely accused of a bunch of things that he didn't do. He's been proven innocent time and time again through his fans, through KTubers, through his company, and even through the Seoul District Police. So I don't know why people are still trying to say that he's a horrible person. So yeah, whenever you come across someone, they don't even have to be a stay, they can just be a Woojin anti in general that supports other groups. Whenever you bring up the point that he was innocent of everything that he was accused of, and that he didn't use the allegation to promote himself, which, by the way, when the initial allegations came out and both Woojin and his company, 10X Entertainment, issued a statement, it came off in very poor taste, like he was saying, oh, well, this weird thing's happening, but I'm working on my solo stuff. No. That was a really bad mistranslation. And by the way, Korean is a notoriously difficult language to translate into English. There are enough miscommunication issues amongst two native Korean speakers, much less someone speaking in Korean, it getting regurgitated through Help Us, a search engine online, because we all know how reliable Google Translate is, and then it gets converted into English. That's just a mess waiting to happen. So the actual essence of what Woojin was saying was, it's bizarre that someone is accusing me of these things, because let's be honest, if you woke up one day and saw the entire world was canceling you for something that you didn't do and don't know why someone's so angry at you, you think it's bizarre as well. But anyways, aside from thinking that it was a bizarre situation, essentially, he also said that he couldn't have done that because he was too busy working on his solo activities. He wasn't promoting himself. He was saying, I have been so swamped with work that I don't have time to be going out to clubs and bars and meeting strangers and blah, blah, blah. I'm trying to get my solo album out, so I don't know why these people think that I have the time to go out and spend time socializing with strangers. So that's really what he was trying to say, that he was too busy working on his solo activities that he didn't have the time to be doing all these things he was accused of. But even once you present evidence and facts to these people that, look, he didn't do anything to these people, they are people living in Brazil that never even been to South Korea, much less met Woojin, and he didn't issue a statement saying to look forward to his solo promotions. If you want to say something negative about Woojin's company, I will say I was not a fan of the tone that the company used for the documentary that they put out about the Woojin situation. I thought it was a little too lighthearted and comedic for my own taste, but aside from that, there's not much else that I'll say people really have much ground in criticizing him for. But yeah, so once you disprove all those claims, it immediately goes back to, well, one, I still think that he is a terrible person, and two, I believe Bang Chan. I believe Stray Kids. Here's the issue with that. When has Bang Chan said that Woojin's actually a terrible person? When have Stray Kids actually said that they dislike Woojin, or that they're happier that he's out of the group, or that he bullied, abused, harassed, or in some cases, people have said that he has done some pretty explicit things to Felix that I am not going to repeat here, but just know that if you are one of the people perpetuating these narratives, you are despicable and disgusting, and I'm going to leave it there. Stray Kids, and Bang Chan specifically, haven't said that Woojin's done anything to that nature. So, where does all this come from, and what actually happened? A lot of people arrive at this conclusion because of things like Felix posted OT8 or something referring to the group now having 8 members as opposed to 9, but that's pretty commonplace. And then people saying, oh, well, the group re-recorded everything. There are these things called royalties. If you have any stake in a song, whether it's production credits, composition credits, writing, vocals, backtrack, anything of that nature, you get paid for that song in accordance to how much effort that you put into it and in accordance to whatever your contract was. As long as Stray Kids' music with all eight of them is being consumed by their fans and the general public, JYP Entertainment is legally obligated to pay Woojin. So whenever you say, oh, well, they're re-recording everything to make OT8 versions, that's the company wanting to save money and not paying someone outside of the company that they don't want to and don't think they have to anymore. That has nothing to do with how good or bad of a person Woojin is. So they'll usually bring up those arguments, and then the most prominent argument brought up is, well, Bangchan gets mad every single time that an OT9 photo is brought up.
Let's see. Stray Kids concert dates. Not this one. Let me see it. This one? Wow, they used an old photo. Come on. Let's use the new photo, please. I mean, it's understandable. Some people might not know, but yeah. Oh, this one too. Come on. Stray Kids. Come on. Member of eight members.
And clearly he hates Woojin and is so happy Woojin's gone, doesn't want to be reminded of him because he's disgusted, but is that really what's happening? And what really got me started on this rabbit hole I've fallen into is something that happened in an episode of Two Kids Room. For those of you who aren't familiar with the group, Stray Kids has a recurring segment called Two Kids Room, where two of the members will be placed in a room. They could either be on a couple of stools, a couple of chairs, on a singular couch. The layout isn't really important, but what is that you have two members and they're just given the opportunity to discuss whatever they want, dish out some of their deepest emotions, and feel very comfortable and vulnerable with each other. And in one of the episodes, you had Bangchan and Soongmin together, and Soongmin was very canon and open about how Bangchan keeps a lot of things from the other members, the staff, friends, family. He is more of a kind of person that likes to internalize things and not really rely too much on other people for support and structure. He likes to really hold all the burden himself.
어떤 사람들 앞에서 이건 절대 잘 안 오거든요. 막 국밥 먹으면서 오는데 아 참 그때만큼 좀 되게 좀 진지하게 느낀 게 좀 많았어. 아 이거 알지 못하는 무게가 되게 많구나. 예. 스테이도 잘 모르는 것도 많은 것 같고 그냥 저도 잘 모르니까 멤버들도 다 하나하나 막 형이 이렇게 뭘 신경 쓰고 하고 있는지 사실.
Really made me think about how even when these idols are more open about their private lives, there's still so much information that we have no idea about. And there's so much information that we will never know anything about, and we really need to learn to understand and accept that. But then that got me thinking, with all this stuff that Soongmin is talking about how Bangchan likes to keep things to himself that even the other members don't know about, much less the fandom. Is anything in that sort of trove of information pertaining to Woojin? I think that Bangchan inadvertently gave us the answer to that. So Eric Nam has a show with Dive Studios, which Bangchan and Felix were both guests of together in the same episode. In that episode, they divulged some information about Bangchan in his trainee days. Apparently, there was a point in which he was a trainee and The rest of the trainees at the time were either dismissed by the company or debuted, just they were no longer going to be in the trainee program, and he was the only one left.
What was the hardest part?
Seeing people come and go. So like you get close to people, but then you know they end up not making it,
right.
Or then they end up debuting before I do.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there was one time, besides me, everyone got cut.
Oh wow!
And right. I was like, well, what is happening here? And then I fell into like a really deep depression. Mm. No, I wouldn't say it's depression, but I was like, I'm not gonna be friends with anyone. Right. I do not want to experience this pain again. I'm not gonna be friends. That's why I was always so. Dark, you know, like, because for them it's like, he's so scary, like, oh, 7 years, how do I approach him?
Grandmaster!
I literally it was a rank.
Yeah.
So what was your first impression of him when you showed up?
I thought he was a cool guy, but then everyone was like, they always have that kind of like, 긴장, like they're nervous, right? But then me, I had like no 눈치. So I was like, oh, hey. And I was like, hey. And then like, it was like you know, just eating normally and then whatever. Like when we did training and all that stuff, then I saw like why people were like nervous of him.
The scary side of
Bo-chan.
Yeah. I'm not like that.
Scary Chan is here.
That's all gone. Yeah, cheers.
Cheers.
I'm sure that pretty much anyone can understand and sympathize with him. How it must feel to be left by yourself and that feeling of loneliness that really consumes you. And Bang Chen was really honest in saying that he became so depressed from that experience, he just cut himself off and isolated himself from all future trainees. He didn't want to make friends anymore. He didn't want to make connections anymore. He didn't want to feel that heartbreak of someone leaving him that he cared about and put so much trust into and that he really thought would be in his life for a long time. And then we have Woojin entering. So after a while, Bang Chen put together a group of 9 people, including himself, that was going to be Stray Kids. And within the group, Woojin served as the primary pillar of support for Bang Chen, as Woojin was the only member in the group that was older than Bang Chen, and then he left and Bang Chen became the oldest, which then led to him being ridiculed by Soomin 24/7 for his age, which we all love him for, but our favorite poor 5-year-old single father of 7 goes through a lot. So yeah, during the survival show, which nobody can convince me wasn't a poorly veiled attempt by JYP, the person, to make a power play and show Bang Chen that, hey, even though you think that you're all that because you got to put your own team together, I'm still the top dog in this company and I make the decisions at the end of the day. That, as well as being a soft drink commercial, but if y'all want my opinions on the Stray Kids survival show, I can talk about that another day. But point is, during the survival show, in order to prove that he was still the head authority, JYP started threatening eliminations to the group, saying that if all the members weren't living up to the standards of the company, they would not be allowed to debut within the group. And thus, first he eliminated Lino, and then he eliminated Felix. And I think anyone who has watched the video of Felix being eliminated and how torn up all the members are, especially Bang Chen, just permanently have that just burned into their mind. And Bang Chen saying, I'm not going to leave you.
So 미안하지만 이번에는 함께하지 못할 것 같다. 함께하지 못할 것 같다.
네.
Always find me, eh? I'm not gonna leave you behind. Yeah?
It's very obvious, in my opinion, that Bang Chen never got over his issues in struggling to let go of people, having to watch people leave. And honestly, it's not something that you get over as an issue pretty easily. It takes a lot of time. And given the K-pop trainee system and how many trainees are constantly cycling in and out of a company, coming, going, debuting, getting kicked out, getting dismissed, deciding to do something else with their lives, you have a lot of people through basically a revolving door coming in and out of your life. At the end of the survival show, Stray Kids debuted with 9 members as they intentionally planned to. According to JYP on the show, he was saying that, oh, the members feel so much sadder and like something's missing. And I'm just like, dude, you never planned on actually eliminating anyone, now did you? But point is, the group got to debut. And then in late 2019, it came out of nowhere that Woojin was leaving the group. So here we have Bang Chen, someone that has clearly been through hell and back and deserves so much credit for how strong he is as an individual. And I'm not talking about physically. I mean, if you guys have watched the recent Stray Kids Codes episodes, then you definitely know how strong Bang Chen is in terms of just physicality and athleticism, but I'm talking about being a strong person mentally and emotionally. That guy has had to endure so much in this industry, and they're only like halfway through their contracts right now. So yeah, you have Bang Chen, this person who just really struggles in letting go of people, losing his primary pillar of support, being the only older member than him in the group, which is Woojin. Combine that with Seungmin talking about how Bang Chen keeps a lot of things to himself, Felix acknowledging that there was a time when it was really hard for Bang Chen to open up to people because of how much he was trying to isolate himself, and throw in how upset Bang Chen seems to be whenever Woojin's photo is included in like a news article or a profile about the group. To me, it just makes the most sense that Woojin didn't actually do anything wrong to the group. That's not why Bang Chen seems to get so upset and is imperative that people use only OT8 photos. It's because Bang Chen is still missing Woojin to an extent. I don't mean like he stays up every single night just mourning the fact that Woojin's out of the group, but he misses Woojin being in the group. He misses having that person that he could rely on. He misses how happy the group was as 9 members. Granted, they are still happy as 8 members, and in my opinion, I think Woojin leaving was for the better because the music that he releases as a soloist is very different in contrast to what Stray Kids releases, and I think Stray Kids as 8 members has been able to really thrive. I'm actually working right now on a video as to why I think that Stray Kids right now works really amazing and why I think that for different reasons I consider them the best group in K-pop, but that is a different topic and we will discuss that another time. But yeah, I'm really happy overall with the fact that Woojin's able to do his own thing and Stray Kids is able to now succeed in a way that they weren't as a 9-member group. But that doesn't mean that Bang Chen is over the fact that Woojin isn't in the group, and that doesn't mean that it's easier for him to get over the fact when Woojin keeps getting brought up. And that just brings me to another side tangent I just want to go on. I very rarely, if not just, I never see Cubs bring up Woojin in straight kids spaces. I don't even think that I've seen an example of that happening. I'm sure there has been at least one or two instances, but just not that has appeared on my radar. But I am constantly seeing stays complaining about Woojin. I remember being so upset that Hyunjin was on hiatus because of his own accusations, and every single video you were just looking for some hint that Hyunjin was still in the group. We had to rely on Felix carrying Hyunjin's school stuffed animal in his hoodie just as a reliance to reiterate or reinforce, there we go, that Hyunjin is still a member of the group. And then when he finally made an appearance in Mixtape O, I cannot express how relieved I was to see him again, especially because he had to sit out through Kingdom. Here I am watching the Mixtape O music video, feeling so happy that Hyunjin is finally confirmed to be back in the group and where stays. On the Still Dream music video and the Ready Now music video, which are two songs by Kim Woojin, bashing him, insulting him, this and that and the third. I'm just like, are y'all actually stays? Do you actually care about your group? Because if you did, what you're doing is not being productive to helping your group succeed. If anything, it makes you look bad, and when you look bad, it's a bad reflection as to what your group is like. And then, same thing. We finally get some Japanese content from Stray Kids, and the first thing that stays are doing is complaining about a clock made by a company with the name Woojin in it, because again, there's not only one person in the world with the name Woojin. There's just so many better things you could be doing with your time to support Stray Kids, yet here you are, wasting it, being toxic towards Woojin. And the more that you talk about Woojin and discuss him, even if you're hating on him, the worse it's going to be, because you're potentially bringing him to the attention of Bang Chan. He wants to move on with his life. He wants to try and just let go of the fact that Woojin left. And yet, here he is constantly being brought up in Stray Kid spaces by Stay that claim to care so much about Bang Chan's mental health and well-being. So yeah, ultimately, again, I don't know why Woojin left the group. I do know it's not because of the accusations, because those came out about a year after he left, and the time frame in which the accusations claimed that the events had happened were also from after he left. So to all the people trying to say he left because of the accusations, even the accusations don't line up with that theory. Personally, I just think that he wasn't feeling fulfilled under JYP Entertainment. We are constantly talking about how trash of a company JYP Entertainment is. Look at GOT7 and how they just were mistreated. Look at TWICE and how they're overworked. Look at how many past JYP Entertainment artists have said they don't really hold any resentment against JYP the person, but they would never work with him or the company ever again. Why is it that we're always talking about how terrible these companies are and how they don't treat their artists properly until it's time to acknowledge that maybe an artist left because the company's trash? Personally, I don't believe that Woojin ever did anything wrong to Stray Kids. I think if you look at all of their content, whether it's variety content, vlog style content, they all seem to be very comfortable around him and feel very safe, and he seemed to really take on the role of the eldest brother and taking care of them. So it just never made sense to me that people thought that stray kids hate him because, quote unquote, he was mean or abusive or a bully to the other members. And then when I saw Bang Chen talk on Eric Nam's show about how upset he was when he saw so many trainees leave and he was by himself and he tried just to isolate himself in fear of growing attached to anyone else and what may happen if that person leaves, to me it just felt like everything clicked all of a sudden. That made much more sense than trying to paint Woojin out to be a villain, because again, just nothing that I've seen him do really substantiates those claims. Anyways, again, that is just my own personal theory as to why I think Bang Chen tries so hard to erase any sort of OT9 Stray Kids representation, why he doesn't talk about Woojin. I don't know. Maybe that's what the issue is. Maybe it's not. You guys are more than welcome to let me know in the comments section if you agree with this theory, if you don't agree with it, what your own personal theories are. As always, I'm open to different opinions, different interpretations. If you think that my opinions are way off and you want to sort of debate them or anything, you are more than welcome to comment below. But again, any sort of toxicity that I see, especially towards Woojin, Stray Kids, other people in the comments, other KTubers, etc., it's going to get deleted. So be mature, be civil. Until next time, stay happy, healthy, and hydrated. Peace out.